Yeah. This is this entire thing of this one. This.
Touch and running the ball instead. It's a runaway try. Campbell Sparrow diving straight into it. Prince Edward costing themselves once again. Tinashe Hombiro being fancy as always, going out there with a fancy pass, and the Mad Dogs are not having any of it. It is 2014. Prince Edward butchering a clean opportunity to get themselves out of danger. Coach making a very good decision now, taking Mumburi out. And Chipumbu can easily kick this one in, making it 22-14 in the next few minutes. And they've got 19 minutes to come back from this one. Prince Edward, very tactical, turning the game around. But those trivial errors all add up into something else. And the ball was turned over where Hombiro was supposed to kick them out of danger. It's amazing how Chifumbu missed that one. He needs to work on his technique, hitting the post, but it's still looking good for Prince Edward. Just 6 points behind. 52 minutes into it, Falcon College leading Prince Edward 20-14. What a game. Prince Edward, so many times finding themselves having to come from positions such as this. And Tinashe Hombiro looking to go right. A deep, long ball. Chifumbu passing it down. Oh, would have used the pace off Owusu. It's a knock on. This could be a defining scrum down for Prince Edward. Just after the 10-yard line. And Tinashe Hombiro has options. The blind side looks nice and open. Play has just been stopped for a little bit. Owusu just being attended to by the physios. He thinks he can stretch this one out. Looks like it's a hamstring. You can see a lot of the boys stretching shoulders, hamstrings, stretching glutes. It's very physical out there. It looks a lot slower because Falcon have done their homework and made this a very physical game. Now looking at that blind side, you've got Rukudzo Ndoro with Tinashe Hombiro. And it looks like they're going to pick and go. But Owusu's watching them, and so is Sifumbu. As predicted, they pick, they go. 4-1-2. Can Prince Edward turn this one around? There goes Ndoro. Ndoro straight into it. Does he offload? Goes down. 5 yards into it. And Falcon putting up their brick wall once again. Hombiro with a pass. A dummy run. 3-on-2. Prince Edward still not finishing. Falcon are looking strong. But not managing numbers very well. Hombiro back inside. Gaining some ground. Falcon trying to turn that one over. Hombiro sidesteps, doesn't offload. Try time, Prince Edward. 55 minutes on, and the pendulum keeps swinging from right to left. This makes it 20-19 in favor of Falcon. And in this kicking position, Hombiro might get this one. And maybe for the first time, Prince Edward will go ahead. So the Tigers are back. And they really want this one. Still yet to understand the structure that Prince Edward are working with. But it looks as though they are putting in their forwards into their back line. One of the hardest working people on the field today, Lawrence Auld, seems to be having a shoulder problem. And the coach will have a chat with him. He's been holding on to that shoulder for a while. And the coach is talking to him too. Assistant coach is talking about taking him out. But he says, no coach, I'm fine. This is the heart of school boys. Falcon having a chat or two. Now the parents are getting in there, screaming their hearts out for their boys. Prince Edward leading Falcon College at home. It's 21-20. It's a one-point game with about 15 minutes to go. Dylan Grant with a great kick. Falcon with Muleya getting into it. They form a V and looks like they're going to go right. Dubois controlling it very well. Falcon using their size to get in there. It's a one-point game. Looks like it's advantage, Prince Edward. Sidesteps. Still looks like the advantage is still on. Hombiro with the ball. Takes a grubber kick, but no one chasing it. Oh, kicked it straight into the gut. And it's been turned over. Match is a lot faster now. And the Mad Dogs have slowed it down just a little. Snyder just getting there with his height and size. Oh, what a good offload from Falcon College. Support not getting there quick enough, and Prince Edward could turn it around. There goes Falcon on the far side. Ref not having any of that. Prince Edward not waiting for anyone. And there he goes. That scrum of Carlos Matematema from a quick tap. And he scores for Prince Edward. Now that is the X factor from the Tigers. No one could have predicted that. Playing outside all forms of structures. He just went for it. A quick tap. Went for it. And now Falcon will pay dearly for this one. Falcon trailing 20-26, and is 58 minutes into it. some good schoolboy rugby action. This is the opening match of the schoolboy season, as schools opened just this week. And it's the first time that these two are meeting each other. The first time that Falcon College is playing in Zimbabwe this year. They're not part of the Dairy Board Rugby Festival, but instead they went to Benoni for an Easter festival where they had mixed results, winning one out of three matches in South Africa. So it's game on. Prince Edward leading 28-20 right here in Eskodini at Falcon College. A bit of a smile and some relief for Sean D'Souza, but he's still on the edge. Medics jumping through, and seems like a lot of the Prince Edward boys are carrying some injuries. I can see the coaches and physios working on the boys. There might be a couple of changes. Injury-based replacements. And the stretcher comes on board. Coach D'Souza not having any of it. Tells the boys to get him up. Get him out. The game must go on. Just a few minutes to play. About 12 minutes to end this match. And Prince Edward with a healthy lead of 8 points. It's 28-20 in favor of Prince Edward. Falcon College struggling at home now. And what a game we have. Do not be fooled. Schoolboy rugby is no child's play. And these boys are tough and mean. Trials are coming through in a couple of weeks. And they all want to get noticed. I see a couple of selectors in the crowd having a look at some of these boys. But that runaway try from Atema Tema, wow, what guts. Nice high ball. This time Prince Edward get it. Is it going to be a more? Looks like he's held up for a little bit. Now he's on the ground. Prince Edward with possession again. They're looking to have a phase. Taking the fight onto Falcon. Regardless of side, they pushed back. Back to their strengths. There they go, Prince Edward with possession. And numbers going left this time. And they're at it. Hombiro getting himself some space. The offload looking clean. A bit too late. And Falcon have it. Coach not very happy with the fact that boys are passing from the top. Now Falcon with possession. They have to hold on to possession for as long as possible. New speed merchant in. It looks like the boys are not entirely fit anymore. Falcon College with another phase. This time Chifumbu sidestepping, but no one to control play. It also looks like Duboyo was held up in that one. Prince Edward trying to hold them up, but Falcon doing justice to them. Chifumbu with a cross-cover kick. Can he get it? Looks like it was in front of the kicker. Is the try given? It looks like the try was given. Malaya getting a kick straight from Chifumbu, right across. Now this becomes more interesting. 62 minutes played, Falcon 25, Prince Edward 28. Does Falcon have a kicker to give them that 2 point, the extra 2 points, just to get them 1 point closer to Prince Edward? Coach D'Souza not very happy with the decision. They believe, Prince Edward believe, that Malaya was offside and he was in front of the kicker. With the way this match has been moving every single 5 minutes, these 8 minutes to be played, there's quite a lot of rugby. Now this kick will determine everything. kick looking as if it's not good. So it means Prince Edward lead 28-25 with about 8 minutes to play. This is unpredictable. I'm mighty impressed by the 9-10 combination from Falcon, Duboil and Chifumbu, causing damage to Prince Edward. Hombiro with a nice high ball, pushing it back, and they retain ball. Prince Edward in a dangerous position. They go down in the middle of the park. Numbers on the right. And there they go with those offloads. Fancy offloads from these boys. Ndoro gaining some ground, goes down. Hombiro with the ball. Some pressure defense from Falcon. Stepped out. Is the offload clean? Ryan Mutando just breaking those defensive lines. It's been turned over. It's Falcon ball. And the kick, not the smartest of kicks. Prince Edward still having it. And it looks like Falcon ball. A knock on from Prince Edward. They retain advantage. 64 minutes on the clock. Falcon College 25, Prince Edward 28. It's a 3-point game. Falcon now finding themselves in a very precarious position because of two missed conversions. 4 points would have given them a nice 1-point lead ahead of Prince Edward. Scrum down, and it's Falcon ball. Prince Edward pushing it. And the ball, so much pressure there in the 5-yard. Looks like a cage match. And then Dylan running straight into Mtandwa, who holds him up. Mtandwa and Dylan still tussling it. It's moving. So it looks like a maul. Riff lifts up a long arm. So it could be advantage, Prince Edward. So brought in by Falcon, held up. And it looks like Prince Edward ball. With just 4 or 5 minutes to play. Falcon College 25, Prince Edward 28. And it's a scrum down. Gideon Maseka, one of the hardest working guys, is put off. And there's Mutandwa. Prince Edward on the far side. Some fancy offload. Ndoro wants to finish through. It's been turned over. Looks like it's Falcon ball. Chifumbu to kick it out for danger. And he steps in and out. A high tackle from Prince Edward. That's a long arm. For the whole time we were calling Lawrence Old instead of Gideon Maseka. They don't find touch. Hombiro gets the ball, goes left. Nice long pass. Prince Edward on the attack once again with some pace and grit. The pass not looking clean. These offloads on the left are not coming out right for Prince Edward. It's Falcon ball. Possession keeps moving. Falcon have numbers. They held up once again. And it looks like it will be turned over again. Prince Edward losing the ball. Ref calling it a knock on. So it's a scrum down to Falcon. The opening match of the schoolboy rugby season. Falcon College hosting Prince Edward. Right now, Prince Edward leading 28-25. It's a three-point game with about 3 minutes to be played. It's all about decisions. Decisions, decisions, decisions. And with so little time, there's calls for Chifumbu to kick the ball out. But possession is golden at this stage. Dylan Grant getting in there. And Masichili trying to secure, but Prince Edward get there early. Falcon still trying to run the ball, but Prince Edward with some pressure defense. And that attempted tackle looked a bit high. And ref calling it. Two minutes to go. Prince Edward leading 28-25 against Falcon College. The decision has been made. And a decision has been made from that penalty. And Falcon opt for the line out. They've lost at least two line outs already. So Prince Edward have a fair chance. And there goes that line out. It's tense. People on the edge of their seats at Falcon College. Prince Edward leading 28-25 with about 2 minutes to play. Falcon going for the sixth ball. They have a chance of getting this one back. Handling errors once again. This time it looks like it's Mabuza. And Prince Edward playing some serious defense. Keeping it clean as well. There goes Chifumbu trying to offload. Falcon on the run on the far side. Can they do it? And they butcher it. That was the last play. It is done and dusted. What a game. Prince Edward running away with it. 28-25 against Falcon College. Coaches shaking a few hands there. And the Tigers have done it. Winning their first game in the schoolboy rugby season in Zimbabwe. It's been a great game. And thank you for streaming and watching this live. You can always share the link. What a game. What a game. Prince Edward Tigers undefeated so far in Zimbabwe this year. Beating Churchill 22-17 last week at the Dairy Board Rugby Festival. And once again, keeping it close. Too close for comfort as well. 28-25 against Falcon College. But the score really reflects what was going on the field. It was really tense, contested decisions, and many things going right and wrong for both sides. The band keeps playing on, and Prince Edward boys just hugging each other, and my. Just looking at some of the names that we'll have to consider for this week, for this year's Craven Week side, Falcon boys have had their hands up. Several boys, Mumburi, Muller and Snyder. Now that pairing can take on any side in Africa. Campbell Sparrow, the eighth man with that runaway try, very alert. Chifumbu is one fly off to look out for. He, in my opinion, he probably had a better game than Hombiro today. He did more for his side than Hombiro did, with the exception of his foot, but he's got some good vision. His passing left and right is superb, and he controls the game very well. But Duboil was the center of Falcon's engine, controlling the ball very well and working very well with the forwards and the backs. But for Prince Edward, it's the X factor. From the centers, I would say Mutandwa was the hardest working center, holding up players, taking on the tackles, breaking lines. It was amazing action. Tinashe Hombiro, great leadership again, but he almost paid dearly for a couple of decisions that he fluffed. One such decision was not kicking for touch when you were supposed to, and Falcon came a little bit too close for comfort. The speed star, Rukudzo Ndoro, was working really hard, but I must give it to the one man, Gideon Maseka. Yes, he got sin-binned, got a yellow card, was out for 10 minutes, but he was one of the hardest guys. He was the bone collector today. Panache Matapure was another clinical one, causing a lot of grief for Falcon College. Thank you very much for tuning in. Catch us next week on the same page. We will be following all the action of schoolboy rugby in Zimbabwe.